So first of all, we learn about basic metabolism, that is carbohydrate, protein, fat metabolism. Let's start. First of all, carbohydrate metabolism. Just think that in what form we consume carbohydrate, that is monosaccharide, disaccharide, polysaccharide, starch, isn't it? Then all of these materials after ingestion, they ultimately break down to monosaccharides, that is glucose, galactose, fructose. So how they break down into these products? First of all, when we consume carbohydrate, it comes to oral cavity. There is an enzyme called salivary amylase which breaks down to carbohydrate in a certain extent. Then it goes to stomach, but there is no enzyme for carbohydrate digestion in stomach. Okay, so further it goes to small intestine. After coming to small intestine, pancreas gives you enzyme called pancreatic amylase. This is very important for carbohydrate digestion, and it breaks down to carbohydrates into disaccharide, some monosaccharide. Then finally it goes to brush border of small intestine, where there is brush border enzymes called disaccharidase. It finally breaks down to monosaccharide, that is whatever you take, it finally breaks down to monosaccharide, that is glucose, galactose and fructose, and they absorbed into our bloodstream. But ultimately carbohydrate metabolized in the form of glucose. So our main topics is metabolism. So here is the main thing. Then what is the fate of glucose that you ingest? So there are three fate of glucose, that is one, oxidized for energy, it can be stored as glycogen or it can convert to other forms like triglyceride, amino acid. Okay, so there are three fates of glucose that you ingest. That one is giving you energy by oxidation, stored in your body as glycogen, or it converts to another form of products, actually amino acid or triglyceride, according to your body requirements. Then how it glycolysis path, how it oxidized or how it gives you energy, there are several pathways. Number one, it goes to glycolysis pathway, then it goes to TCA cycle, that is tricyclic acid cycle or Krebs cycle, whatever you call, and finally oxidative phosphorylation. There is no need to read elaborately all of these pathways, just read the name of the pathway, read the entry product and the end product, and finally what you get from that pathway. Just read this, no need to read all of steps. So in glycolytic pathway, it glucose enters, and finally what we get? Pyruvate and 2-ATP. It can occur in aerobic pathway, it can also occur in anaerobic pathway. But if it runs in anaerobic pathway, we will get lactate instead of pyruvate. Okay. And this pyruvate enters into TCA cycle after converting to acetyl-CoA. And after round this cycle, I already gave you the picture of the cycle in your Telegram group. This cycle gives you carbon dioxide, water and 2-ATP. Okay. And there are some electron carbons actually which enters into oxidative phosphorylation to give you final energy, and approximately oxidation of 1 mole of glucose give you 38 ATP. How 38? 2 from glycolysis pathway, 2 from TCA cycle and 34 from oxidative phosphorylation. So these are the one mode of metabolism of glucose. Do you understand? Or do I need to repeat?
Repeat, please.
Okay. First of all, one important thing is when we take carbohydrate, what are the forms that we usually take carbohydrate? That is, one is polysaccharide, it may be disaccharide, it may be monosaccharide. But whatever you take, it ultimately it goes to monosaccharide to absorb as well as to metabolize in your body. So after ingestion, first of all, it comes to oral cavity. There are salivary amylase, one of enzyme, which breaks down your carbohydrate into a small amount to disaccharide or monosaccharide, and then it goes to stomach. There is no change in stomach as there is no enzyme there. Then it goes to small intestine. There we get pancreatic amylase. Okay. This pancreatic amylase breaks down your carbohydrate into disaccharide and monosaccharide in a large form. And finally, it breaks down to monosaccharide by the disaccharidase enzyme, which is located in the brush border of the small intestine. So finally, you get your monosaccharides after digestion. These monosaccharides enter your bloodstream by absorption, and finally you get the glucose for which is ready for metabolism. And what is the fate of this glucose? There are three fates of glucose. One is giving you energy by oxidation. Number two, stored as glycogen. And number three, converted to other forms like amino acid or triglyceride according to your body requirements. And what is the pathway responsible for oxidation of glucose? Number one is glycolysis pathway, where glucose enters as a form of glucose, and end product of this pathway is pyruvate in case of aerobic condition. But in anaerobic condition, we get lactate instead of pyruvate, and 2-ATP. Because I am reading this pathway to know about the amount of ATP, amount of energy, what we get from glucose. Okay. So after getting pyruvate, this enters into Krebs cycle or TCA cycle, whatever you say. From this cycle, we also get another 2-ATP and also hydrogen electron actually, which enters into finally oxidative phosphorylation, where you get 34-ATP. So finally, one mole of glucose oxidation responsible for production of 38-ATP, two from glycolytic pathway, two from TCA cycle, and 34 from oxidative phosphorylation. This is the one of the fate of glucose metabolism. Okay, glycogenesis pathway is not very important to learn. Mainly TCA cycle is very important for exam actually. So no need to read glycogenolysis actually. You can read or for your own interest to learn more, but for exam it's less important actually. Most is glycolysis, TCA cycle, these cycles are very important.